Please welcome to the stage, Gahee Kang.
Hello. My name is Gahee Kang, and I'm happy to present my thesis, Digital Natives. My journey began with this movie, Amelie. This scene brought me back to my childhood memories, when I was touching and making physical things in real life. But when I see children today, they look different. Now kids start their screen life from a very early age. The result is, kids can eat without the screen. Kids can poop without the screen. They even want to see a screen when they are at a park. This is the reality, and I think it's totally crazy. One of my parent interviewee, Adam Fujita, said, "We didn't grow up in the digital culture. It is scary that we don't know what digital technology is going to do to our kids yet." Adam and most of us here are digital immigrants. We have immigrated from the analog world to the digital world. But young children today, they are digital natives. They see smartphones and tablets in front of their faces as soon as they are born. I talk with many experts in this field. I interview educators, family counselors, pediatricians, and children product designers, and mapped out the negative influences of digital technology for children. The consequences are terrifying. They include a sedentary lifestyle, lack of diligence, lack of verbal communication. But we have to agree that there are many great things too, such as access to open resources and community. So over the past 7 months, I explore and prototype many ideas. I started with this co-creator workshop called Smart Fun. Kids are encouraged to run around the park and find characters that are hidden, and kids capture them on their phones. This photo became the character in a board game. In this moment, I started to see how digital and analog behaviors can be blended. Do we really need to get rid of their phone? I think we can reuse them in an analog way. In my thesis, I created a series of digital products that creates analog behaviors for digital natives to bridge the generational gap. Let's dig a little bit deeper. Digital products are often addictive and create passive behavior. So I design an app that is addictive but create proactive behaviors. Mission Fun Possible is an application that encourages children to do off-screen activities by providing mission on-screen. Because some cognitive behavior only develop while children are doing off-screen activities. For example, to develop a creative thinking, kids need to make story instead of watching them on YouTube. Or to develop an analytical thinking, children need to actually say their thoughts out loud. The application's user flow is designed with the principle of gamification and social network to get children addicted to doing analog activities. Mission Fun Possible has an avatar, Jelly. Jelly is like a friendly mission commander. Jelly celebrates and rewards when a user completes missions. When a player gets a mission like make your own dessert recipe with strawberry, Jelly shows examples of how other kids did the same mission. Jelly also asks children to move by giving a mission like move like your favorite animal. Now you can see the app is filled with children's movements. Now let's dig a little bit deeper again. Texting is very linear way to download your thoughts. However, with a piece of paper and a pen, you can express your thought in any creative form you want. You can use color and a combination of images and text. Introducing Ola, the drawing messenger. Ola delivers handwritten or drawn messages Let's see how all that works. Let's take a closer look at Ola. Ola simply has three buttons and a notification flag on one side. The user journey is designed with a very simple structure, so it interacts with young user just like an analog mailbox. So what's next? It must be virtual reality. Because virtual reality is the obsession right now. But when children are in virtual reality environment, they see shapes and characters that are generated by computers, designed by others. So I wanted to do something different. In this project, I reached out to one of my subject matter experts, Jaehyung Kim, who is a game designer. And together, we made a partnership with Children's Museum of Art located in Soho. We designed an experience called If I Write VR. With the 360-degree camera, we digitized the magical box that children built with their hands. But we don't just put VR on children's head. We use a stationary bicycle to let them move. We use the same technology as Google Street View, but in this case, instead of clicking with a computer mouse, children pedal to move forward. As the wheel passes the sensor, it creates a forward motion in virtual reality software. Let's see what happened in this design experience. The learning doesn't stop after the workshop. As a takeaway, we gave them stickers because kids love stickers. Kids fill in the sticker board as they're taking action to help marine animals and climate change. If they eat less meat, they fill it in as a prize. When they collect every sticker, children open the app and use Google Cardboard to see their sticker board. When the app detects the image of completed sticker board, a 3D image pops up as a reward. Children see what will happen when they're actually taking actions. What if we commercialize this experience, but as a product for individuals? So I created ScubaScapes, a pair of augmented reality swim goggles. It is an attachment that can be applied to any scuba mask. Children wear the mask while swimming in a pool. And the device project, A View of Ocean Life. Here we can teach children through hands-on experience as they are physically moving and playing. As I'm finishing my thesis, I'm excited to see how the young digital native will get to enjoy technology in a healthy and fun way. And at this point, I have to admit that I'm a little jealous. I wish I could be a kid again. I want to send a special thank you to my family in Korea. 엄마, 아빠 보고 있어요. 사랑해요. And thanks to Jaehyun, who was my amazing partner on the VR project. And thanks to Wonu, who made me feel like I'm home in New York City. And thanks to all my 14 lovely classmates who supported me in this two-year journey. Thank you. And many thanks to all the faculty. And thank you, everyone.
I love that your point of departure was like, this stuff is not going away. I also love that you took existing things and put them together in a new recipe that is kind of remarkable. Now this If I Ride VR like has a life. So what is the next step for this?
So the experience was successful. So Jaehyun and I, we are continuing partnership and we are going to San Francisco to participate Maker Faire in this month.
Great.
That's exciting.
And then there's a Maker Faire in New York in September, so that might be a logical step after that. Unless you go to San Francisco and stay in San Francisco.
Yeah.
Which I suppose could happen.
If San Francisco is too far for you guys, then we are doing another workshop at the Museum of Moving Art on June 18th. So you guys all should sign up for that experience. It's going to be fun.
And how long will that be up?
It's one day workshop.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. I wish we had it in the lobby. Wish we had a lobby. So the idea is that we will be able to create our own environments using plasticine or whatever tools, maybe different tools as grown-ups, although grown-ups love plasticine, and to make the environments and then to film them, and maybe a faster bike, a bigger bike, a combination of open source, crowdsourced. And again, some designerly magic fairy dusk. I think it's just such a great project. And hearing the audio at the end of just their delight is very, very inspiring.
Yeah, kids loved it. They don't understand what's VR. They just do it and then, oh my gosh.
Again, like digital natives, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's using the tools that they're already growing up with in ways that leverage your point of view and gonna make their lives healthier.
Yeah, that's very exciting.
Yeah. Plus, we're pre-designed for happiness, right?
Yes, of course, always.
Thank you, Gahee.
Thank you. Okay.